Planning applications are made up of one or more cubes that store metadata and data. The number of cubes you create depends on the needs of your organization. For example, if your sales department has a yearly revenue plan and your finance department has a profit and loss plan, you can define two cubes: revenue and P&L. As you manage dimensions, members, and data in the application, you associate them with cubes. The association ensures that the cube contains only relevant application dimensions, members, and data values, and that application design, size, and performance are optimized. You can share data between cubes. For example, the revenue cube may include several sales detail accounts that roll up into a total product sales account. You configure the P&L cube to include the total product sales account and omit sales detail accounts. Then, bring in the data value for total product sales into your P&L plan without account details. Cube Editor lets you view or add cubes in your application. Depending on the type of application you created, you can add up to a total of 7 cubes, 3 block storage cubes, and 3 corresponding aggregate storage cubes, plus 1 consolidating aggregate storage cube, each with a unique aggregate storage application name. Here are the cubes in my custom enterprise planning application. I'll create a cube. Enter a name, select a type, aggregate storage or block storage, and enter a description. EPM Enterprise Cloud Service and EPM Standard Cloud Service subscriptions are deployed with an S-based version that supports hybrid block storage option cubes. Custom planning modules other than workforce enabled, and freeform applications are created by default to use hybrid BSO cubes in place of BSO cubes. When you create a block storage cube, you can select the option to enable sandboxes. Sandboxes enable planners to keep their work private from other non-administrators as they develop their plans. Here's the cube I created. After the cube is created, you cannot rename or delete it. Refresh the database to commit the changes to the application. Depending on the changes you made, refreshing the database takes a moment to complete. Next, let's take a look at clearing cubes. You can clear specific data within input and reporting cubes. You can use this feature to reload or correct data in your cube. For example, you might have loaded data into the wrong intersection or simply need to prepare the cube for the next cycle. Enter a name and select the cube to clear. Then, select Clear Options. For BSO cubes, you can clear all data or clear the data in upper-level blocks, non-input blocks, dynamic blocks, or empty blocks. For ASO cubes, you can clear all data, all aggregations, or partial data based on a point of view. Review your selections before saving the job. I'll refresh the contents of the page to display the job I created. You can run the process right away or schedule it to run later. Use the Actions menu to delete or submit the job. Running the Clear Cube process deletes the data you specify within input and reporting cubes, but it does not delete the application definition in the application's relational tables. Let's go to Jobs to verify that the job completed. The Clear Revenue job completed successfully. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.